not looking forward to the trip. It's going to be a long day for us, but I'm sure once we get over there, we'll get set for the first match, and you know, we're all looking forward to it.
The first night we got there, there was an evening meal, and Mick said about the training kit hadn't arrived. The training pitch wasn't as good as he thought. And as soon as Mick said that, I thought it must be bad. I couldn't believe it. I really couldn't. So I went to Mick's room that night, about half an hour later, and I said, I'm disappointed with it, and I left it at that. But towards the afternoon, the storm clouds were gathering. I just knew it. Nobody spoke to me. And I went for my meal at 6:30 on the Thursday, and I was told there was a meeting at 7:30. And Mick came in, and I knew what it was about. Mick was the one who called it in front of everybody else and said I turned my back on the players, questioning my loyalty to my country. I wasn't going to sit there and say, excuse me, Mick, I think you're a little bit out of order. And I said to him at the meeting, I said, you're a liar. And I walked out of that room, and I walked out of my international career.
The Irish team manager Mick McCarthy has informed the FAI that following a team meeting today in Saipan, that he has requested Roy Keane to leave the squad and return home.
I can't, will not tolerate the level of abuse that was thrown at me. So I have sent him home.
When I went back to my room, my solicitor rang me. He said, oh, you're coming back. And I said, well, how do you know? He said, well, there's been a press conference. And I said, no, there couldn't have been. I said, the meeting just finished about 15 minutes ago. It's been a press conference, Rob. I've just seen that in the news. And that really bugged me as well, you know.
And this is from the players. This is the players' statement. It reads, regrettably, the manner of Roy's behaviour have left the staff and players in no doubt that the interests of the squad are best served without Roy's presence.
Where is Roy Keane now? Is he still out in Saipan with the squad?
Physically, I don't know where he is, but I presume he's still in Saipan and arrangements will be made to take him home.
Roy, can you give us just one reaction being sent home from the World Cup?
I made my own arrangements, come back. FAI weren't really the most helpful, to be fair.
Can you give us any insight into what happened last night?
No.
Can you even tell us how you're feeling at the moment?
I feel very good. Clear conscience. And I'm happy to be going home. Happy to go home and see my family.
Any regrets at all?
No regrets.
Not even about playing in the World Cup?
There's more important things to worry about.
I think that Roy should apologise.
No.
No.
No. No! 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 Definitely not. He's nothing to apologise for.
Yeah, I think he's let himself down. I think in a couple of days he'll wake up and he'll wonder why he gave up the chance to play in the World Cup for Ireland.
He got us to the World Cup. McCarthy was there as a leader, but he's no leader now.
We're all very disappointed, you know, because, you know, at this stage he's letting his country down, you know.
I think Roy Keane's been treated very badly in this. I don't condone what he said in his outburst, but I certainly think that, you know, Mick McCarthy's been a long time pro. He should be able to take a more reasonable stance in it.
Come back, Roy Keane. Look at Roy Keane.
I've been frustrated for many years now regarding with the Irish setup. I made a few points over there and a lot of people weren't happy with that, and ended up with an argument with the manager, because I think the buck stops with the manager. I think it's his job to make sure things are right for the team, and it wasn't, and I said it, and there you have it. I'm in Portugal on my holidays. I couldn't believe we went to Saipan to train when the island doesn't have a football pitch. You tell me, what are we doing in Saipan without a football pitch? I know it was 2 weeks before the tournament, it was a time of relaxation, but barring injury, you need to train on a secure training ground. And of course, the first 1 or 2 days, we picked up 1 or 2 injuries. It's as simple as that. The evidence is there. The Wednesday, I spoke to two press lads who
a bit of time for two decent riders, I think, Tom Humphreys and Paul Kimmage. And I made my point to him that, you know, I was disappointed with certain things. And Thursday morning there was an interview gone in the Times, which I'd sort of read myself, and it was fine. And Thursday night there was a meeting organised. And as soon as the meeting was called, Mick said, oh, certain people aren't happy things. And I says, I'm not. Which I told him the other night in a private meeting anyway. And I said to him at the time, why can't we do this in private? He says, well, you've made it public by your... And he pulled out an interview from his back pocket, as if maybe to catch me off guard. And I said, I've already read it. And I stand by what I say. It's one or two players sitting in a press conference saying, oh, we couldn't believe it. And these lads, you know, Muppets. There's anything I can describe them. To sit there and to say what they said about me, hypocrites, you know, these lads. Cowards. Cowards sums them up. And I mean that. I will not go back on that. Ambush, maybe. I wasn't going to sit there, and especially when Mick made the accusations about me, which seemed to have been swept under the carpet a little bit, about me faking injury. So for him to accuse me that was the biggest insult. I told him that he was wrong, and I didn't fake injury, and that I didn't respect him as a manager, as a person, or as a player. He said, well, if you don't respect me, you can't play for me. And I left the room. It was over.
Look at Real Madrid, they keep